हेलो मेरे स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू केमिस्ट्री क्लास बेटा। सो अप टू नाउ एज पर एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑल द प्रिपरेशंस ऑफ अमाइंस वी हैव स्टडीड क्लियरली। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो क्लास सम मोर एक्स्ट्रा प्रिपरेशंस ऑफ अमाइंस आई एम गोइंग टू बी डिस्कस नाउ एंड दोज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स लाइक मे बी नीट और मे बी फॉर जी मेन्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एंड मे बी फॉर सीईटी पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। ओके ना बेटा, so some more extra preparations of amounts we are going to be discussed now. So let me consider one by one what are the preparations are there. Okay, in that number one case I am going to consider that reaction name is nothing but the Schmidt reaction. What is the reaction beta? Schmidt reaction. Yes, so now we have to know that what is mean by Schmidt reaction, how it is responsible for the preparation of amines. In this Schmidt reaction we have to use a particular reagent. The reagent name is nothing but the using HN3. The meaning is nothing but using hydrazoic acid. So in Schmidt reaction, first of all we have to consider carboxylic acids are bonded to COOH. So we have taken, what is the reaction beta? Carboxylic acid. So as per Schmidt reaction, when carboxylic acids undergoes reaction with HN3, means they are showing reaction with what beta? Hydrazoic acid. They are showing reaction with what beta? Hydrazoic acid. And Schmidt reaction, it going to be takes place or okay now, in the presence of a suitable catalyst, that is nothing but the concentrated H2SO4, nothing but concentrated sulfuric acid, it going to be act as catalytic substance. Now finally here we are going to get the product, that is nothing but the primary amine. So what is the formula of primary amine beta? Are bonded to NH2. So its name is nothing but what beta? We are to consider that primary amine. Next one is, here actually in hydrazoic acid HN3, three nitrogen atoms are there. Out of three, one nitrogen we have covered in the form of primary amine. Remaining two nitrogen atoms we can remove or we can eliminate in the form of nitrogen gas. And remaining here, carbon contains two oxygen in carboxylic acids, that form we can eliminate in the form of the gas is nothing but what beta? CO2 gas. Okay, so what we can write the statement for this Schmidt reaction? What is mean by Schmidt reaction? Carboxylic acids on reaction with hydrazoic acid in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid forms primary amine by the release of carbon dioxide and what nana nitrogen gases is. In that way we have to write the answer. So acetic acid means in the place of R we have to write CH3. By considering acetic acid we will get the product is nothing but methyl amine. If we consider benzoic acid, in the place of R we have to write benzene, nothing but we will get the aniline. Means we can prepare primary amines only from carboxylic acids upon reaction with what beta? Hydrazoic acid. So what is the formula of hydrazoic acid beta? HN3. This one you have to be focused. Clear nana? Good. Now here I am going to consider that method number two for the preparation of amines. The method number two is nothing but I am going to write the name of this reaction. It is known as Curtius reaction. What is the reaction? Curtius, or we can say Curtius as you wish. So this is nothing but Curtius degradation reaction. What is the name of this reaction? Yes, its name is, we have to say that Curtius degradation reaction. So what we have to degrade in this Curtius reaction? Again, how to prepare the primary amine? But from the starting reactant is acyl chloride, R bonded to C double bond O, C double bond O bonded to Cl. So what is the name of this compound? Its name we have to say that it is nothing but the acyl chloride. When acyl chloride, or we can say acid chloride, when it shows reaction with NaN3, reaction with what beta? NaN3. So what will be the name of this compound? NaN3 means name of this reactant is called sodium azide. Which azide? Sodium azide. This is the formula of NaN3, sodium azide beta. So when acyl chloride undergoes reaction with sodium azide, now Na plus combines with Cl minus and it goes to be eliminated in the form of NaCl. R bonded to C double bond O, such acyl group, I am going to be right here as it is. Next, Na plus combines with Cl means that will be removed in the form of what beta? NaCl, and remaining is nothing but N3 minus. So that N3 minus may have to be right here. That means RC double bond O, what is the name of this compound? Acyl. And N3 is nothing but what? Azide. So acyl azide, this is your what, Nana? Or we can say keto azide, this is your intermediate product. Followed by such acyl azide, upon heating, it loses the what, Nana? Nitrogen, I mean N2 gas is going to be lose. After the loss of N2, here we are going to get another intermediate. R bonded to C double bond O. C double bond O connected to N. Total here 3 nitrogen, but N2 removed beta. Remaining is only 1 nitrogen atom. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nitrogen contain 5 valence electrons. Now such intermediate compound, it will undergo the process. Okay, now yes, now it will undergo the process. I want to consider that is nothing but the rearrangement, or we can say that intramolecular rearrangement. Okay, so which type of rearrangement takes place, beta? Intra rearrangement will be takes place. Nothing but in within the molecule, an atom or group that will migrate from one place to another place. Especially here, alkyl group that will undergo migration from carbon to nitrogen atom. At the same time, this lone pair going to be delocalized here. So due to such intramolecular rearrangement, or we can say alkyl migration, we are going to get the product is nothing but R bonded to N. Actually here R bonded to C, but after migration or rearrangement, R bonded to N. And lone pair delocalization is going on, means a single bond become double bond. And C double bond O group is there, that group we have to write as it is. So this is your intermediate, its name is nothing but alkyl, NC mean isocyanide, but NCO means isocyanate. Same product already we have got. In the reaction is nothing but what, Nana? Hoffman bromamide degradation mechanism. Alkyl isocyanate is the intermediate. So finally, it undergo the process alkaline hydrolysis by using 2 moles of aqueous NaOH. So this step name is nothing but what, beta? Reaction name is called alkaline hydrolysis. Alkyl isocyanate upon alkaline hydrolysis, bond going to be break between nitrogen to carbon. Now in 2 moles of NaOH, 2 H atoms are there, they are provided to the nitrogen. So we can write in the form of RNH2. So what is the name of this compound? Primary amine is the final product. R bonded to N, N will take 2 hydrogen from 2 moles of NaOH. Next, remaining beta. So C double bond O group that will undergo the process degradation, same like Hoffman method. C double bond O group, it will undergo degradation in the form of what? Same, Nana, in the form of, you have to say that Na2CO3. In the form of what? Na2CO3. 2 sodiums are there, Na2, and here carbon contain 1 oxygen, here 2 oxygens are there. Total 3 oxygens means we can remove in the form of Na2CO3. Everything will be balanced. Okay? So acyl chlorides on reaction with sodium azide and followed by heating and followed by alkyl shifting, it forms an okay, very important intermediate that is nothing but alkyl isocyanate. Finally, it upon alkaline hydrolysis by using 2 moles of NaOH or 2 moles of KOH. It forms the product is, main product is primary amine. C double bond O group, C double bond O group, it will be degraded in the form of what beta? Na2CO3. Clear? Good. For the purpose of objective point of view, preparation number 3, in the amine preparation, the name of this reaction is called Buckler reaction. Already this reaction, up to now 2 to 3 times we have studied. Sir, what is mean by Buckler reaction? It is a very suitable reaction for the preparation of aromatic amine, that is nothing but aniline. But we can prepare that aniline from the starting reactant. So name of starting reactant is, I am going to be write that, its name is known as what, Nana? Phenol. So by using phenol in Buckler reaction, we are going to prepare the aromatic amine, that is nothing but aniline. So conversion of phenol to aniline by Buckler reaction, very very important reaction. Let me consider phenol forming. Benzene bonded to OH, nothing but C6H5 bonded to OH. It is nothing but what beta? Phenol. And you suppose, as per Buckler, in this reaction, phenol will undergo reaction with ammonia. Phenol on reaction with what beta? Ammonia. And it going to be takes place in a particular catalyst. So what is the catalyst in Buckler reaction? Question was repeated. So that is nothing but the anhydrous ZnCl2. What is the question we are going to consider beta? Yes, we are going to consider that anhydrous ZnCl2. So phenol on reaction with ammonia in presence of anhydrous ZnCl2, by considering a suitable temperature around 573 Kelvin or 300 degrees Celsius, automatically here we are going to get the product aromatic aniline, I mean aromatic amine, that is nothing but what beta? Aniline means benzene bonded to NH2. Of course, aromatic aniline, but it contains NH2 form, so we have to say that it is also known as primary amine. So what will be the byproduct? From phenol we have to remove the OH group. From NH3 we have to consider H atom. H then combines with OH minus and it goes to be eliminated in the form of water molecule. In the form of which molecule? Water molecule. So from NH3 we are removing H, and from here we are removing OH. When H plus combines with OH, we are going to be eliminated in the form of water molecule. After loss of H plus from NH2, NH3, the NH2 group will be there, that NH2 will be adduced upon benzene. So we are getting what, Nana? Phenyl amine, or we can say that aniline. Anyway, it is also nothing but what, Nana? Aromatic primary amine. So statement, phenol on reaction with ammonia in presence of anhydrous ZnCl2 at 300 degrees Celsius gives aromatic primary amine, or simply you can say that aniline as additional. Now method number 4, I am going to show you. This is the preparation of aniline from where? Phenol. Now, again I want to give you preparation of aniline from chlorobenzene. From what beta? Chlorobenzene. So how to prepare aniline from chlorobenzene? In Buckler reaction what we did, we have prepared aniline from phenol. But here we are going to prepare phenol, we are going to prepare aniline, but from where, Nana? Chlorobenzene. Yes, let me consider chlorobenzene. Formula is nothing but C6H5 bonded to Cl. It is known as what beta? Chlorobenzene. Chlorobenzene, you suppose it undergo the reaction with what beta? Ammonia. Chlorobenzene upon reaction with ammonia, but especially in this reaction we require, as per balancing, 2 moles of ammonia chahiye. And in this reaction we require a particular catalyst, that is nothing but cuprous oxide. Cuprous oxide. And this is the reaction going to be takes place by using suitable temperature 200 degrees Celsius. Again same thing, position of Cl, it goes to be occupied by NH2, means C6H5 bonded to NH2. Name of this compound is called aniline. It is an example of aromatic primary amine. Next, sir, what about that Cl? That Cl goes to be removed in the form of a byproduct. The byproduct is nothing but the 2, okay, na, NH4Cl. Ammonium chloride is a byproduct. Na. So again, if you want, you can consider go for balancing also. In 2 moles of ammonia, why we have taken 2 moles of ammonia? One nitrogen in the form of NH2, another nitrogen atom in the form of NH4Cl. Everything going to be balanced if you want to get check. Okay, so statement, chloropenzene on reaction with what, Nana? Ammonia. Chloropenzene on reaction with ammonia in presence of Q plus oxide at 200 degrees Celsius, that gives the product is nothing but what, beta? Aniline is the final product. Very good. Next thing is, I'm going to show you the another reaction, that is nothing but the reduction of alkyl azides. What is mean by alkyl azide? Alkyl means that will indicates the formula is nothing but R, alkyl. Azide, what is the formula of azide? N3. What is mean by NaN3? Sodium azide. What is mean by RN3? Alkyl azide. Alkyl azide. When alkyl azide, when it will undergoes reduction, the meaning of reduction is addition of hydrogen. It is nothing but what, beta? Reduction. Addition of hydrogen or reduction we can consider by the using suitable reducing agent. So what are the reducing agents we can consider in this reaction? That is nothing but LiAlH4, means lithium aluminium hydride. And also we can consider that sodium in presence of ethanol. This one also we can consider. If you want, you can consider another one also, that is nothing but NaBH4, means sodium borohydride. Any one of the reducing agent out of 3 you can consider, automatically alkyl azides, they will change this into the again primary amine. So what is the formula of primary amine? R bonded to NH2. Here we got the product is nothing but what, beta? Primary amine. Let me consider in azide, number of nitrogen atoms are 3. What, one nitrogen in the form of NH2, remaining 2 nitrogen atoms, they goes to be eliminated or evaporated, I mean liberated in the form of N2 gas. So alkyl azides upon reduction with any one of the reducing agent gives primary amine. In the place of our CH3, methyl azide, so it will use methyl amine. In the place of our ethyl azide gives ethyl amine. In the place of our benzene, phenyl azide gives aniline. Like that, number of products you can get from the topic is nothing but reduction of alkyl azides. Okay, good. Now let me consider preparation of amines in that 6th method. That is also important for the competitive point of view. Yes. So method number 6 one I am going to consider now. Which method? 6th method. That is nothing but the reduction of all the oxymes, or we can consider the ketoxymes. All the oxymes and ketoxymes, again they undergo the process is nothing but reduction by using suitable reducing agent. Again they will give the product is nothing but primary amine. Which amine? Primary amine, beta. Okay, let me consider aldoxime. What is the formula of aldoxime? So I want to consider the acetaldoxime. What is the formula of acetaldoxime? Means when acetaldehyde undergo reaction with hydroxyl amine, in the topic of aldehydes and ketones, oxime formation is very important. Yes. So acetaldoxime formula got CH3 bonded to CH. CH double bond O. This is the formula of acetaldehyde. when it undergo reaction with what beta? Hydroxyl amide means NH2OH. So from here we have to remove H2, from here we have to remove O after the loss of water molecule. CH3 bond CH, double bond N, N bonded to OH. CH3 bond CH, double bond N, N bonded to OH. So this is the product. Okay, its name is nothing but what, Nana? Oxan, but it is coming from acetaldehyde. So we can say that it is known as acetaldoxan. Acetaldoxan, it undergo the process is nothing but what, Nana? Reduction. It undergo the process is nothing but reduction, means addition of hydrogen will be takes place. Addition of hydrogen. So aldoxans or maybe ketoxans, they can be reduced by the special reducing agents. Reduction will be takes place by using lithium aluminium hydride in presence of supporting solvent is nothing but ether, or you can consider sodium in presence of ethanol, that is nothing but what beta? C2H5OH. So by considering any one of the reducing agent, automatically aldoxans or maybe ketoxans, they must be converted into primary amine. So formula is CH3 bond CH. I am going to write the product here. CH3 bond CH. CH3 bond CH, that group I have written as it is, but it undergo the process of reduction, means addition of hydrogen will be takes place. And now you suppose one of the H atom that was given to the CH, means we can write the CH2. After addition of one hydrogen to the central CH, double bond becomes single bond. And it connected to what is the atom? Nitrogen atom. Okay, I have written there as it is. Total we are providing 4 hydrogen atoms, out of 4 only one given to the central CH, nothing but going to be act as CH2. Remaining 3 hydrogen atoms are there. Remaining 3, okay, now out of 3 we are going to add here 2 hydrogen atoms. So out of 4, 2 given here and 1 more is given here. Remaining 1 H atom is there and 1 OH group is there that can be removed in the form of water molecule. So the main product is nothing but primary amine, byproduct is nothing but water molecule. NH2 means primary amine, but one carbon means meth, two carbon is nothing but eth. So name of this compound is called ethyl amine. What is the name of this compound? Ethyl amine. It is an example of what beta? Primary amine. Thus, so not only aldoxans and ketoxans, upon reduction with any one reducing agent, okay, they will give the product is always primary amine. Yes, one example of aldoxan I have given to you. Now let me consider another example for ketoxans. So ketoxan, best example, acetoxan we have to consider. What is the formula of acetone? CH3 bonded to C double bond O, again bonded to what beta? CH3. What is the name of this compound? Acetone. When it undergo reaction with hydroxyl amine, means NH2OH. Again, from hydroxyl amine remove H2, from acetone remove O. Nothing but what we can write? C double bond N, N bonded to OH, N bonded to OH. So this is the product name, not acetone now. Acetone on reaction with hydroxyl amine, it forms acetone oxan. Nothing but an example of ketoxan. When such acetone oxan or ketoxan, when it undergoes reduction by using same reducing agent, again by the addition of hydrogen, also same thing, 4 hydrogen have to be added, but reduction will be takes place in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride, in the presence of what, Nana? Dry ether. And also we can consider this reaction sodium in the presence of what beta? Ethanol. Like that they have to be considered. Automatically that OH, it will consider one H atom from reduction and it will be eliminated in the form of water molecule. Remaining your product, what? CH3 bond C. Okay, I'm going to write that CH3 bond C. To that central C, we have to provide one hydrogen. Okay, I have provided one hydrogen. Above plane, it was connected to methyl. Okay, above plane, it was connected to methyl. And so out of four providing hydrogens, one given to the OH in the form of water molecule, another H given to the C in the form of CH. Remaining two H atoms are there, they will provide it to the nitrogen atoms, that is in the form of NH2. Again here also NH2 group is there, means it will confirms that amine is nothing but primary amine, but one carbon, two carbon, three carbon, they are in the form of isoform. So we can say that isopropyl amine, it is the common name of this compound, but by the presence of NH we have to say that it is also an example of what, beta, primary amines. So final statement I am going to repeat now. Maybe aldoxanes or maybe ketoxanes, they undergo the process reduction by using suitable reducing agent. Both they are going to be formed, the product is nothing but what, beta, primary amines. I hope you understand this reaction clearly. Yes. Now, let me consider another reaction, beta. Reaction number seventh one we can consider, that is nothing but the reductive amination of reductive amination of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, so here two steps are involving, aldehydes and ketones. They undergo first of all amination, means reaction with ammonia, addition with ammonia, followed by we have to do reduction. Again here also you are getting from aldehyde and from ketone, the final product should be primary amine. Let me consider how. So one example I am going to consider, first of all by considering aldehyde. Again same aldehyde I want to consider, that is nothing but the acetaldehyde. What is the formula? CH3 bond CHO, or we can say CH double bond O. It's your formula. About what? CH3 bond CH double bond O. So name of this compound is called acetaldehyde. What is the name of this compound? Acetaldehyde. When it undergoes amination, that means upon addition with what, beta? Ammonia. The formula is nothing but NH3. This reaction already we have practiced in aldehydes and ketones topic. Aldehydes upon addition with ammonia, definitely there will be elimination of water molecule takes place. Sir, how? From acetaldehyde we have to remove O, from NH3 remove H2 combines with O and will gets eliminated in the form of water molecule. So after the loss of water molecule, what will be the product? CH3 bonded to CH, CH3 bonded to CH. Here double bond is there, okay, such double bond I am going to write that as it is, CH3 bond CH double bond, okay. Here nitrogen atom is there, I am going to write nitrogen. Out of three, two removed in the form of water molecule, remaining atom is only one. So try to remember, aldehydes and ketones upon addition with ammonia, they are going to form the product is called imine. Yes sir, no, beta. So this is the formula for imine, but this is the imine coming from where? Acetaldehyde. So we can say that name of this compound is called acetaldehyde imine. Now such acetaldehyde imine, step one is amination, okay. Step two is nothing but reductive or reduction. Four moles of hydrogen was added in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride. It going to be act as what, Nana? Reducing agent. Don't need to add four moles of hydrogen. Otherwise, we can do simply hydrogenation. Which type of hydrogenation? Catalytic hydrogenation we can do, Nana. In the presence of maybe nickel or platinum or palladium. Okay, what will be the product now? The product is nothing but the CH3 bonded to CH. We are doing hydrogenation, means we are providing two H atoms. Out of two H atoms, one was given to the CH, converted into CH2. Another was given to the NH, NH becomes NH2, and double bond becomes what, Nana? Single bond. This is your NH2 form. Its name is nothing but what? Primary amine. but exact name is methyl amine, 2-carbon means ethyl amine. So its exact name is nothing but what beta? Ethyl amine. And IUPAC name is nothing but the ethanamine. Common name is nothing but ethyl amine. But pakka, this is an example of what nana? Primary amine. So step one is amination. Step two is reductive or hydrogenation. Simply aldehydes are converted into the primary amines. So acetaldehyde contains 2-carbon. Primary amine should contain 2-carbon. That is nothing but ethyl amine. In that simply we can take the answer. Next gopher, I want to consider the ketone. So ketone best example I want to consider, that is nothing but acetone. CH3 bonded to C double bond O, it connected to what is the group beta? CH3. Okay, I have taken the compound is nothing but acetone. Acetone upon step 1, that is nothing but amination. So amination means what beta? Addition of ammonia will be takes place. From ammonia remove H2 and from acetone remove O, and we can eliminate in the form of water molecule. Remaining we are getting the unstable intermediates, that is nothing but imine. CH3 bond C, above plane is nothing but CH3. C double bond N, okay, C double bond N, and one hydrogen will be there. So this is known as imine. But imine coming from where? Imine coming from acetone. So we can write that name of this compound is called acetone imine. Now such acetone, I mean, undergo the process reductive, or we can say that hydrogenation in the presence of what beta? Either nickel or platinum or palladium. Okay. Now the product is nothing but the, we can say that CH3 bonded to C. What will be the product, Nana? Yes, the product is nothing but the CH3 bonded to C. To that carbon, we are providing one hydrogen atom. And it connected to double bond becomes single bond. Again, another H atom connected to NH, means NH becomes NH2. See, above plane one methyl group is there, that methyl group I have written as it is. So by the presence of NH2, again we have to say that it is also an example of what, Nana? Primary amine. But what is the name? 1-carbon, 2-carbon, 3-carbon, propyl amine. But it is in the form of iso. So name of this compound is nothing but what beta? Isopropyl amine. What is the name of this compound? Isopropyl amine. So aldehydes and ketones, first of all they undergo amination and they will form imine is the intermediate. Followed by such imine, it upon hydrogenation, they're going to be formed, the product is nothing but primary amine. So aldehyde contains 2-carbon, it will form ethyl amine. Acetone contains 3-carbon, it will form propyl amine, but we are getting isopropyl amine. Okay, now one more reaction I want to tell you. That is nothing but the decarboxylation of, what is the reaction beta? Decarboxylation. Decarboxylation of alpha amino acid. Decarboxylation of alpha amino acid. So let me consider first of all formula of alpha amino acid. Important formula you must be remember. Okay, that formula was useful for biology and also for biomolecules chemistry chapter also beta. Yes, what is the formula of alpha amino acid? R bonded to CH, CH bonded to NH2. Alpha amino. First suppose CH carbon is alpha. Alpha connected to NH2 means alpha amino, okay. But alpha amino, what is the group is there? Acid group is there. So we can say that COOH. This is the formula of alpha amino acid. I mean, this is the general formula of amino acids. Where it undergoes the process heating, and yes, simply we have to be considered that heating will be taking place in the presence of barium hydroxide. So alpha amino acids upon heating with barium hydroxide, it going to be loses the COO, nothing but that was removed in the form of CO2. Removal of CO2 from alpha amino acid, we have to say that decarboxylation. So after decarboxylation upon heating with base, what will be the product? R bonded to CH, okay. But after loss of CO2, that H atom will be given to the CH. Now CH becomes CH2. That H atom will be attached upon alpha. Already alpha contain one car, hydrogen. If we here we are getting another hydrogen. So CH and H, H2, it connected to NH2. R bonded to CH2, CH2 bonded to NH2. NH2 means what? again we have to see that primary amine. So alpha amino carboxylic acids or alpha amino acids upon heating with strong base barium hydroxide after decarboxylation, here we are going to get the product is nothing but again what beta primary amine is the product. Another 2 to 3 competitive preparations are there, and after that physical properties of amines that we will continue in tomorrow's video class. Okay na beta, good.